gimmicks for you heavy duty truck owners. We also have brand new 2024 Ram 2500 Crew Cab 4-wheel drives priced to sell starting at $49,997. We'll do whatever it takes to make you a deal between now and Monday night, so come see us today. Don't worry about your credit. At Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade, and also a hassle-free buying experience. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood, or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. We also have free delivery to your house or work.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more. At the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Right now at Fort Thompson, Smith & Wesson Shield, 2.09 millimeter, $269.90. Beretta APX-A1, 9mm, $199.90 after $50 mail-in rebate. CCI 9mm brass, 50-count box, $12.99 at Fort Thompson and Sherwood.
From the Eat My Catfish Studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports here on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. And we will be joined by Matt Zimmerman. Thanks to the DHR group of Sonic Drive-Ins for this final time with Matthew. And I'll say this much, gentlemen. It may not be Sweet 16 excitement in basketball for the Arkansas Razorback basketball fans, but man, I'm feeling the excitement all the way down here in Little Rock for tonight's basically Sweet 16. I won't say Final Four, but this kind of matchup, that's kind of excitement with LSU coming to town. Yes.
Well, what's up, Rick?
There he is.
There we go. Yeah, he's just talking about the excitement, Matt, of Arkansas playing LSU tonight. They're going to be, I think, big crowds tonight, tomorrow night. And before Matt comments, I'll just say this. It is 68 degrees. There is no wind. This is one of the most perfect days I've seen in a long time. What a great night this is going to be for baseball.
Yeah, you're right. I'm looking out my window and to the right, and you can see them lined up in the Hawk pen. And when I left yesterday, it was like 6 o'clock, and there was like 20 chairs set up. There was one guy sitting there manning all those chairs. But when I came in this morning, it was like 8:45, and there was like 20 people out there, and now there's probably, you know, a couple hundred people lined up and getting ready to, you know, they're ready to go. And it's really interesting when that gate opens for our hog pen devotees, they run. They get through the scanner, and then they take off running. And they physically run down to the front of to that rail, and they all get lined up the hog pen. It's an amazing thing. Just a little spot of land. You know, we put up to 4,000 people there before. But Rick, you're right. It's 2 days ago we played UCA. It was a super cold day. It was nasty. It had been raining. It was really windy. And it was one of the smallest crowds I've ever seen here. At the first pitch, there was literally like 12 people in the hog pen.
Oh, my goodness.
You never see that.
12?
I don't know what we call the attendance, but I'd say the high attendance. Of course, there's suites. People can be up in the suites, too, so it's hard to say. But, you know, there was no more than 1,000 people. It was cold, you know, and as the game went on, people started bailing out. And just 48 hours later, it's like a whole different place. It's perfect weather.
Perfect weather tonight. 73 tomorrow, 77 on Saturday. great weather for the Arkansas LSU series.
Yeah. And this is, Matt, a special weekend, if you will, for all of Arkansas sports, because you've got not only Arkansas LSU, you will have Arkansas softball. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah.
Softball. They will be playing. And then you've got the, it's not the red-white game yet, but it's a major scrimmage for Arkansas football, which means you got a chance starting about, what, Rick, 9 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah.
And it can be nonstop Hog sports throughout the rest of the day.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. And now softball took off this afternoon. They're heading
They're at Georgia. Yeah.
So, but you're right on everything else. And there's no, I don't think there's any track. They're out of town. They're gone. Half the track is at Stanford. But as far as, yep, there'll be baseball the 3 days and nothing on Easter Sunday, which is nice. And then the spring practice continues and a lot going on over there. And so they practice. They've been going Tuesday morning, Thursday morning, and then these next couple Saturdays open to the public free, so you can come out and watch the football team on Saturday morning. That's pretty cool.
Matt, do you get dizzy sometimes with all the activities going on campus? I mean, you can look out your window and you can see baseball kind of right behind you is track and field, or at least down the street, since it's now probably moved all outdoors. But then you got Bogle Park that's just kind of across the hill from you. So does it get you do you get kind of dizzy sometimes with all the sports that's going on there in Fayetteville?
Yeah, March, April is super busy, and it's a lot like November when you still got football, and volleyball's wrapping up, and men's basketball's going now, and women's basketball's going. And, November is super busy, and then this time of March and April, where everyone's playing. You got spring football in the middle of the mix. They end April the 13th when they're done. And so, there's just a lot to do. And then for me personally at the foundation, I try to do a lot more stuff as far as work-wise during this time, because I'm fortunate enough to be with Rick and them during football and then with my basketball responsibilities. So I don't have any excuses during this time of year. So I got to, do some other work with the foundation. But it is neat. There's a lot to do. But at the same time, it kind of does make for, a little bit long days. We love it. But you come in, you work all day, and then you don't go home. You stay, and you go to the baseball game, and you talk to folks, and you visit with folks, and head home 9, 10 o'clock, and be back in office at 8 o'clock the next day or 8:30, and roll through another day. So it's a lot going on. It's fun.
Are you dizzy with what's going on right now? Speaking of all the events going around you, it's another season called the transfer portal. Are you dizzy, Matt, trying to keep up with the transfer portal?
A little bit, because it's. There's two parts of it. The number one part, the most important part, is our team and what we have going and who's coming in and, who's here on visits, who's coming in this weekend, who's coming in next week. So that part is the busiest part. And also just I love college basketball, and so I love to keep up with what's going on. So when guys leave throughout the country and they're transferring, and there's so many of those right now, trying to keep up with what's going on with them. Sometimes it's very hard to keep up. Some of the guys hit the portal and they keep it quiet, and you don't hear much about where they're visiting, who they're talking to, and all of a sudden they make a decision. You're like, oh, so-and-so from Vanderbilt is going to Texas A&M, and so-and-so from Texas A&M is going to Texas. And so a lot of that's kept quiet till they announce, but some of it is very public, and some of the guys really like attention, and so everything they do is out there. And just keeping up with the Razorback portal is very busy. At the end of March, all of April, and really he's got most of his roster done by the 1st of May, but there's usually one or two or three things that still may change. And then Memorial Day weekend, he's going to have them all here. And last year, I thought it was done Memorial Day weekend, and then we ended up adding, Denaje Harris later, even after that. So, it'll be interesting, these 13 scholarships, and who fills them. Another thing that's unusual about it, guys, is it may not even be 13 anymore, because the NCAA allows 13, but then like last year, you got NIL, right? So young men can get paid name, image, and likeness. and may not be on scholarship. And then you add somebody else. That happened to us last year. We had Keon Minifield, remember? And then they said, hey, we're going to take him off scholarship because they were worried about the eligibility. So he stayed here and, you know, had to do stuff through NIL to bring his money in. And then you still go get another scholarship guy. So you don't really have to stop at 13 anymore. If you got NIL money, you might have 14, you might have 15, you might have 16. I don't know how you're going to play that many guys. And we've had trouble playing that many guys. But there's really no cap on the number anymore.
You know, you're down there all the time. This may be an unfair question for you. We've asked those who cover Razorback basketball. There are four guys that have not entered the transfer portal and made any kind of announcement.
Yeah.
Do you know if any of those guys will be back next year? Do you think Muss is going to keep any of them?
Definitely. So I feel like all four of those guys, because we got beat 2 weeks ago today, and we knew we weren't going anywhere. I mean, we had a losing record. You're not going to make the NIT. And so the season was over 2 weeks ago today against South Carolina. And, of course, those other guys jumped in the portal quickly, which kind of is what you have to do to if you want the best options of schools to go to. The only other thing is to try to your hand in professional basketball. We got four guys that hadn't done anything. So I'm so old school like yourself, Rick, so I just assume if they hadn't said anything and you need to move quick nowadays that you're going to be back.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want to get into the – Well, they hadn't said anything. That I do feel like if you hadn't done anything, you're supposed to be back. None of those guys are seniors. They all have eligibility, so they should be back. They hadn't announced for the pros. Now, will all four of them be back? I sure wouldn't bet my life on it that they're all four back. I would not, just because that's just the way it is at Arkansas and a lot of places now. But obviously Brazil, Battle, Tremont, Mark, and Bayfall, they're scholarship guys. They've got eligibility left. And they can be back, so I would expect to see them playing for the Razorbacks.
You know, you weren't involved in all these discussions we were having with one of our guests who continued repeatedly said he thought may lean toward Musselman being gone before next year.
I don't know why he would ever even think that.
No, and I wasn't sure of any of that either. But I have to tell you that this is kind of funny. So I saw a friend of mine today, and the first thing he told me is, "Well, I guess Musselman is officially staying now." And I said, "What do you mean?" And I said, was there some kind of announcement or anything? He says, no. He just said, I figure, you know, he's still. Where do people come up with all this stuff?
Yeah. I don't know who said that he was leaving. I know there was a lot of rumors in Central Arkansas, but to me, there was I never thought. Now, anybody can leave. They can up and move.
Sure.
Just throughout the history of time, there have been very few that have left Arkansas football or Arkansas basketball coaches because you're going to get paid well here. It's a high-profile job. You get a lot of attention. And there's not too many people that have left here on their own. You would know better than me, Rick, of the history of that. But, you know, like, say, a Ken Hatfield, you know, who did. But there's been very few that have left here on their own. You just don't leave Arkansas. I never thought, and I said this on with Wes Moore and them on their show last week and this week, and I don't think he's going to go anywhere. And it was just an easy thing for me to say because there was not, within the industry, there was never any, like, he's going to A or he's, like, he's not Louisville or SMU. You don't leave Arkansas to go to SMU. You just don't. You just don't. Not if you're trying to win a national championship. And so I never thought there was anything real serious that he thought about. And I do think he likes it here and his family likes it here. And he's one of the highest paid coaches in the country. Is he the number one? No, but he's very highly paid. And that's a good thing for him. And so it was going to take a tremendous offer from somebody, and there was not those kind of jobs open this year to me that would even make him want to go somewhere. So I think it's good. It's the stability. He'll be going into year six. He's been here a long time. I think he'll have the bulk of his staff back. And, you know, if you keep those top three scorers right there and add some guys that can fit in and be a part of it, then you got a chance to have a better – team than we had this past season, which wasn't a good team.
You're right. Now, let's go back to the NIL. Yesterday, Hunter Yurecek sent out an email about, you know, they're trying to get 5,000 people in the edge. I get that. But in the email, there was something Randy and I were a little bit confused by. It said, and we realize you can't use TV money, you can't use money that comes to the athletic department in the NIL. But he also said coaches can't be involved. Can coaches give to the edge there are tax deductions. I know they can't pay their players, or you can't, but right. can coaches right. give to the Edge?
No, I don't think so. And maybe they can now that's a little separate. I know when it was one Arkansas NIL, which was ran a little bit closer by to the university. Yeah. It was its own separate LLC, but it was ran closer. We did have coaches that are paid well in Arkansas that wanted to do that, which who wouldn't? I mean,
right.
you have a lot of money, and it might be the difference you getting somebody. We did have coaches. As a matter of fact, I was taking a check from a coach, not football or basketball, at the foundation to deliver it to one Arkansas because he wanted to do it, and it was all legal. And one Arkansas, it was like, we just can't, no. We can't have our coaches pay an NIL. That would be like a coach almost paying a player. Mm-hmm. And so, no, the coaches, no matter how highly paid they are not supposed to be giving to any name, image, and likeness. It's a conflict of interest, and it is using your own money to get a player or to keep a player or whatever. So it is not allowed. They can get out and try to sell it and help encourage it and help raise the money for it just like they can help raise money for the foundation or for Learfield. But, you know, there's a lot of big buckets right now at this university, and they all have to be heavy. I say it all the time, and I know y'all hear it from we have NIL money. We do, and we just need more. And we do have name, image, and likeness. Do we have football players getting paid? Yeah, we got a lot of them. We had basketball getting paid? Yeah, most of them. We have baseball players getting paid? Yes. We've had track athletes get paid? Yes. And so – There's a lot of kids that are getting an opportunity to make more money and to do better than they could without NIL. And is it at the top of the nation? Probably not. Is it the bottom of the country? Is it in the middle? No. Nope. I know it's not. And there is NIL money here, but you got to have it in this league.
Matt, there is a lot of confusion that is being created. This is off of Yahoo Sports. And it is a video, and Hunter Yurecek gives Arkansas fans an answer about Eric Musselman's future. And it
really?
Says, yeah, in this video, Yurecek hops on one of the Razorback transit buses, or in this case, the Mus bus, only to find out Eric Musselman is at the wheel. Yurecek promptly asks, wait a minute, you're still here, suggesting that the two-time Elite Eight appearing coach will indeed stay at Arkansas. Then I get this post by way of our live feed feedback saying, this from Will, says, hold your horses on this video, folks. Apparently Mus is not happy. HY, which I assume that is Hunter Yurecek, posted it or didn't sign off on it. X is blowing up about it, and a post Curtis Wilkerson posted about it. Also, Mus has not retweeted the video as well. So figure that one out as the intrigue continues.
Well, Hunter is pretty smart, and he's not just going to – that was from his Twitter account this morning when he did that.
Correct.
So he's not just throwing stuff out there. He's just not like, hey, I'm going to post this like we're going to, you know, make sure everyone knows that Coach is going to be here. He's not going to post something that like that if he thinks he's not going to have him. Hunter's pretty smart, and I may be wrong. I've not thought all this year of 2024 that he was going to be leaving. And may be wrong, but have not ever felt that. I think he's a coach that likes being here, and he knows that he can win it here, and he can win the whole thing. This is the 30-year anniversary of Arkansas winning it. And we had dreams of winning it this year and didn't make the tournament. You know, but I do think that I don't think Hunter's just going to throw that out there without – feeling pretty good that his coach is going to be back.
I think the added speculation to all this is only being heightened. You mentioned you can't see an Arkansas coach leaving to go to SMU. You
right.
mentioned Louisville.
Yeah.
One of those dominoes, once you start one domino in the process of falling, then there's another domino that is now, who knows what stage it's at, but the USC coach, Southern California coach, is rumored or is expected to be the next coach at SMU. So now you have all this speculation cropping back up again. Well, is Eric Musselman now going, he wants to get back to the left coast, he wants to get back to California in some form or fashion. Well, that's Los Angeles, which is not that far from San Diego.
Right.
Now you got USC. Is Eric Musselman headed to USC? I mean, I cannot blame Hunter Yurcheck, on the other hand, if he did do this, if he did finally say, Eric, we need to put an end to this. You know, this is it's driving our boosters crazy. It's driving any prospects we may have for the NIL. You could go on and on. And even possible signees, these high schoolers who signed in the early signing period. So, yeah, I'm with you. I don't think Hunter Yurcheck would just – let's just throw this up against the wall and see where it leads us.
That's right, because he's a marketing guy. That's his whole background. Everything he's done throughout his career came through working athletic department marketing shops. Hunter, he's very good with it. He's smart with his marketing, and he's not going to throw that out there to be embarrassed 2 days later by somebody else getting his coach. And so, I never felt like he was going to leave. I mean, if there would have been maybe some other jobs, there's just not very many. You know, he's the 12th highest paid, right in there, you know, and I think that eight or nine of those, maybe it's eight that are ahead of him, have won a national title or been to a Final Four, you know, so he's in a good spot here. And maybe an SMU can come up with that and pay him more. They draw 5,000 people a game this year. Arkansas's got a building that's a little less than 20,000. It's sold out every game. Why would you want to? None of that makes any sense to me. I just don't see how you could leave that. And I think Coach Musselman, he's a smart basketball guy. He knows that too. You know, when Coach first took the job, people said 3 years, 4 years. I was like, he's never been the head coach at Arkansas. You know, Arkansas's a darn good basketball job.
Mm-hmm.
And you just don't up and leave it. You know, you just don't up and leave it. And it's as good. It is a tremendous job. There's very few jobs that are like Arkansas basketball job. It's a special job. He knows that. And so, he's still, through 5 years, a popular coach. Our fans love him. A lot of our fans worship him. And so he's in a pretty good place. And, why leave that?
Well, it's called social media. It is also called the rumor mill that's been around forever. And anytime that I can go back. Now, Matt, I wasn't as, in fact, I know I wasn't as closely connected with Rick now as it was back then with Coach Richardson. I spent half my time at Seattle in the 1995 Final Four chasing down rumors that the next coach of the Atlanta Hawks was going to be Nolan Richardson.
Yeah.
And then if it wasn't that, it was Michigan. Or if it wasn't this place,
Ohio
it was
going
to be that place. Yeah, Ohio State. So, I mean, that's how long has this been going on? And I'm sure there were that many rumors going back about Coach Sutton. And if you're successful, you're going to have these kind of rumors. All right, Matt, hang tight.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Registration is now open. Go to 103.7thebuzz.com to register your four-person team. Prizes will be awarded in both the morning and afternoon flights. The 2024 103.7 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka and brought to you in part by Lion Legal, with special thanks to Corky's Ribs and Barbecue, Sonic, and Michelob Ultra.
The experts agree the best 2024 eclipse viewing coordinates happen to be the parking lot of Guatney Butte Gym C next to Sam's Club in North Little Rock. To celebrate, Guatney Butte Gym C is holding a total eclipse solar sale from now until the end of the month. Eclipse glasses are getting very hard to find, but Guatney Butte Gym C has them. Stop in today and pick up your free pair of eclipse viewing glasses while supplies last. And test drive the latest from Buick or GMC while you're there. Get to Guatney Buick GMC to take advantage of the current offers, because when it gets dark on April the 8th, this sale is over. You have to get to Guatney now, because they won't hold another solar sale until 2045. 2024 GMC Terrains at 0.9%. plus $1,500 purchase allowance with approved credit. 2023 Buick Enclave at 0.9% APR, plus $500 purchase allowance with approved credit. Guatney Buick GMC next to Sam's Club in North Little Rock. We are professional grade.
Mark Normand. You don't say, Tor.
Hate the small talk. Two things I can't do, small talk and eye contact. How sad is that, you know? I basically have all the traits of a serial killer, just without the ambition. I'm working on it. People always say, Mark, gotta be more confident. They say, Mark, gotta be yourself. I'm like, well, you gotta pick one.
Fresh off his Netflix special, Soup to Nuts, see Mark Normand live on stage this Saturday at Robinson Center. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
This is the Pigskin Preacher, bringing you the word. In 1983, Bonnie Tyler sang, "Turn around, every now and then I get a little bit lonely and you're never coming round. Turn around, every now and then I get a little bit tired of listening to the sound of my..." Tears. Turn around, bright eyes. Indeed. Now, right now, some of you are thinking of the Dan Band and laughing. 40 years later, Arkansas is ground zero for eclipse viewing. Come by Double B's and purchase your eclipse viewing glasses so you can watch safely without going blind. Like everything else, Double B's has deals on everything you need, from eclipse glasses to drinks to toast the eclipse to other things to cheer you up if you're going through a total eclipse of the heart. Double B's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Double B's.
For Pulaski County residents and businesses, do recycling right by recycling old electronic equipment. How? Come to North Little Rock Simmons Bank Arena parking lot on Tuesday, April 2nd or Wednesday, April 3rd for an electronic recycling event. Learn more at recyclingunplugged.com. If it's electronic and no longer usable, drop it off and we'll recycle it for free. For information, go to recyclingunplugged.com.
I love it here in Arkansas. It's a great place to live and work, to raise a family. You got beautiful scenery, tons to do outdoors, and we love our sports. Arkansas is just a great place. It's one of the things I like most about First Security Bank. They started years ago right here in Arkansas. And after 80 years of growth, First Security is still only in Arkansas. That means we invest in people and businesses right here at home. They have local roots, and they're proud of them. I don't know about you, but that means something to me. At First Security, you bank with professionals who know what they're doing. They also know you and your community. So whether you need a personal or business checking account, a credit card, help with a loan, or just want to ask someone a question, First Security is your home for friendly local support. Stop by one of their 70 convenient locations or check them out online at fsbank.com. First Security Bank, only in Arkansas. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, where it's much like any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners. You've got Drive Time Sports locked in on the Buzz Radio Network. Here is Randy Rainwater.
Drive Time Sports in the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. We will be rejoined in a moment by Matt Zimmerman. Thanks to the DHR Group of Sonic Drive-Ins. If you want a new Chevy Trailblazer, Guatney Chevrolet is the place to go. They are Arkansas's largest dealer of Chevy Trax and Trailblazer SUVs. Guatney has a sleek black 2024 Chevrolet Trailblazer LT on the lot in Jacksonville. It can be yours for as low as $24,490. That's right, $24,490. Hurry to Guatney Chevrolet in Jacksonville at 1301 T.P. Watt Drive, better known as the Gregory Street exit off of 16767 in the heart of downtown Jacksonville. Look for that huge American flag. For a fantastic deal on a feature-filled Chevy Trailblazer compact SUV and start blazing your own trail. That's Chevrolet. Together, let's drive. Once again, joined by Matt Zimmerman, by way of the DHR Group of Sonic Drive-Ins. And let's see. This from our live fan feedback. Mark says, "Guys, I'm hopelessly sad and downtrodden of our genius AD Juracek's handling of Musselman, according to multiple reports. Musselman did not approve of the video HY tweeted today and is actively pursuing other jobs. Hunter Juracek has completely failed as an AD. My hope and dreams are gone like a penguin in the desert. Cry myself to sleep with my pink fluffy cat, Mr. Ninny Muggins. All hope is lost. Poor no. Mark, you've been lost for a long time,
no,
buddy.
No credibility to that.
He has been wandering all over the woods for years.
That's right. No credibility.
Full court, Freddie says Darian Ford was returning until he was asked not to fairly late in the process. We don't know exactly when he found out that apparently he wasn't welcome. But anyway. Marianne. Oh, Rick, here we go. Marianne. N-I-L. Rick, I tried to tell you a couple of years ago that coaches and university employees absolutely can't contribute to NIL. I remember you arguing with me.
Well, it's easy to argue with Marianne, but, that's why I asked, because they can contribute to the Razorback Foundation. In fact, they're encouraged to do that. But that's why I asked about can they give to the Edge, because it sure seems like that if you're given to a tax-deductible gift, it seems like you could. But I get what Matt's saying, conflict of interest. You're paying your own players, so I get that.
And the foundation is not into NILs, correct?
No.
Yeah.
No, that's right.
Didn't think you were. But
the two highest salaried state employees in the state of Arkansas are Sam Pittman and Eric Musselman. So it seems like they would be good candidates to give if they could, and I'm sure they would if they could, but if they can't, they can't.
Yeah. And wouldn't that be interesting, though, if you were allowed to do that across the country and you could keep up with, hey, so-and-so's head football coach is giving $1.5 million of his salary a year to this collective, and the basketball coach is only given $200,000. You know, you could compare and contrast coaches all across the country. It'd be awesome. But, again, we thought there for a minute that you could do it. But they did not take any of those, and they said, no, you can't give. It's paying your own players, and you can't do it. So it's really interesting. I think down the road it's going to end up being that revenue share that all the ADs at first were talking about will never happen, and now it's like they're all talking about that's the next thing is going to be revenue share. And if they do that, then probably the collectives will go away.
Yeah.
The real NIL will still be there, the real, you know, being able to – do commercials for UAMS, that will be there, and those whoever gets selected to do that will profit and make money from that or from other companies that want to do actual endorsements and NIL, and everybody else will get paid off of the revenue share.
Well, that's the way it has to go, because the bottom line is athletic departments. The reason this all came about is because athletic departments are making so much money. But the way the rules are now with the NCAA, they can't use any of that money with their own players. It's got to change. And I've brought this up before. Arkansas always, there's 565 student-athletes. Okay, if that's right, give them each $30,000. That's a little less than $14 million. You got an athletic budget of $160 million. I think they can find $14 million for their student-athletes out of $160 million. And then everybody's happy, and you're not asking your fans to give to the same fans who are already giving. You're not asking them to give more.
Right, and that is part of the problem that you have now is that a lot of the same people are being asked to give to the foundation, their annual fund, to keep their tickets, to keep their parking. Obviously, you know, some of them are even tied into Learfield through the sponsorships. You have people that have to give to the University of Arkansas, the Alumni Association, and also now you got name, image, and likeness. It's a lot of people hitting up the same people for money.
All right, Matt, I've been asked this by several different people. Well, actually, it comes up in a discussion. I shouldn't say that because it makes it sound like they just asked me this one question only. What can be done with the NIL program that would allow for transparency? Because I've got so many friends, and we've had this discussion. Some hesitate even to give to the Edge because they don't really know where their money's going to. And they don't know exactly what this athlete is, quote, making compared to some other athlete. And we're not comparing offensive linemen to quarterbacks. We're just talking in general. So do you see any way? I know the foundation gets into a lot of these legal issues, these legal gray areas, but one thing that's been absolute from the day one of these NIL deals has been lack of transparency. No one has any idea, except for maybe the individual who is receiving the NIL, the player. It may be the person or business or the entity that is supporting that athlete.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, obviously, when it was one Arkansas NIL, they knew exactly what they were paying the kids. But if the kids also were getting NIL through actual endorsements, then one Arkansas didn't know what they were getting outside of that. And there's really no way to, at this time, that there's nothing that those kids have to say, this is what I'm making elsewhere. And so it does make it unusual. And, of course, where the coaches really hate it is, like during this time when there's an open portal with a kid that you're recruiting from another school telling you, hey, so-and-so said they would give me $500,000 to play basketball for them next year, and you're offering me $100,000. And they can make up numbers. And it's very difficult. It's hard. Coaches often call buddies at other schools that they have a relationship with saying, hey, they're saying you're offering this. I've known that to happen. A lot of times guys don't want to say what they've offered because it's all hide and seek and it's all moving numbers around. At the end of the day, somebody's got to pay it. A lot of these schools, at the end of the month, they've had trouble paying their NIL. These were the stuff that was set up before, contracts that were made with these students through collectives. And a lot of these places, these collectives are having trouble paying some of these bills because these coaches are making – it's just part of recruiting. This is not – this is around the country. You know, coaches are telling kids, you come here, you're going to make this. And when the NIL first started, the NCAA was like, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this. And now, as you know, it was a month ago or whatever when the NCAA said, hey, we're done chasing this. We can't control NIL. And so it's even gotten – more wild in the last month since the NCAA made that ruling. They said, we're not going to do anything with NIL right now. So there's definitely coaches around the country that are telling kids, you come here, you're going to make $400,000 to play basketball. And these numbers are huge, $300,000, $200,000. Guys that, there's guys that play on football teams that are second, third string, they'll make $50,000, $60,000, $70,000. These kids are also on full athletic scholarship. And so it's wild. It is wild, and it's sustainable.
We've heard that before.
A lot of money.
Yeah, we have heard that before, and I keep saying it's a rolling snowball that you've got to continue to feed that snowball because some drop off from one year, then you add others on. Sometimes the numbers are greater that you're adding than what you may have had the resources even the year before to provide for. So,
it changes. It's hard. But, Randy, it's got to get back to, you got to have kids that they've got to want to be at your school. And hopefully it's not just because that they're going to make $500,000 playing football.
I agree that totally, man.
They want to be there, and they want to be a Razorback. Now, you say, well, you got to put – like Oakland. Look at Oakland. They didn't have any NIL, and he set up on the podium. Greg Camp, you've been there 40 years. He tuned to his players and said, we didn't have any. They got NIL after they beat Kentucky. The great shooter, Jack, got all this NIL after the game. That, to me, that's what it's all about. He got hit up by Buffalo Wild Wings and these other places, and they threw money at him right then after he'd earned it. He'd beaten Kentucky. He'd helped beat Kentucky in the NCAA tournament. And Kentucky, probably everybody on their team's making names in July and making a lot of those highly acclaimed freshmen were making a lot, no question. And so you got to have kids that want to be there. So you're saying, well, that's Oakland. They can't win the national championship. We're Arkansas. We're trying to win the national championship. Well, first off, we didn't make the tournament this year. And second off, you can still have a great basketball team without everyone making $500,000 on top of their scholarship.
I agree. Thank you. Thank you so much for saying that. I'm so tired of hearing you have to have this and you have to have that. No, you don't.
Right. No.
Thank you.
You don't
thank
have
you.
To.
Yeah.
And we didn't have it in 1994, but it's a different climate. But is Arkansas ever going to be in this climate? Are we ever going to be where our basketball players make zero? No. our fans wouldn't allow that because we're always going to be able to take care of NIL to a degree. But it don't have to be all of them making huge amounts of money, and maybe it's not as successful of a team. And so our guys are going to be taken care of. It. Arkansas always have been, will be, and within the rules of the game.
All right, Matt, hang on. We've got one more segment with you. Hang tight. That is Matt Zimmerman. Thanks once again to the DHR Group of Sonic Drive-Ins. Drive Time Sports will continue in just a moment.
Registration is open for the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course, presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka.
Hi, Oaklawn Race fans. Nancy Holt is here to tell you that the best bet in all of racing is bet.oaklawn.com. Watch and wager on horse racing from any track with your smartphone, tablet, or personal computer, and earn points for cash back for every dollar wagered. New members can earn up to a $150 sign-up bonus by using promo code BUZZ24. Don't miss the action this Saturday on Arkansas Derby Day. Doors open at 10:30 for the 13 race card and a first post of 12:30 p.m. Top three-year-old fillies in the country will compete in the Grade 2 $750,000 Fantasy Stakes. Then Southwest winner Mystic Dan and Rebel winner Timberlake take on the best three-year-olds in the country in the Grade 1 $1.5 million Arkansas Derby. Don't miss out on Arkansas Derby Day fun in the infield and catch all the amazing action this weekend and all season long with bet.oaklawn.com.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale through Monday at Bradford Marine and ATV at all six statewide locations. Blast to the boat show deals like the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury with trailer and up to a $2,000 Bass Pro gift card and discounts up to $10,000 on select models. Or check out the SunTracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with 115 horsepower Mercury outboard. Don't miss the Open House Sale today through April 1st at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Your authorized Ranger and Tracker dealer.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm.
Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's Best Warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR on the Tucson or pay only $369 a month with zero down payment. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 469-613-0227 for details.
Looking for a great place to work? How about going to doublebees.com and apply online? I mean, it is a great place to work. Each and every morning, start my day off right. I head to Double B's because I want the bean to cup coffee. And what that is, it is a selected roast that I can grind and then produce a hot and fresh cup of my Renoco coffee. I can also check out the Renoco Cappuccino. And the great thing about Double B's, they've always got those monthly specials. In a hurry, you can always pay at the pump with your Exxon or Phillips 66 mobile apps at all stores. Be sure and sign up and pay with your Exxon credit card, and you'll get 10 cents off a gallon at the pump. It is at Double B's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. Make it Double B's.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, you feed your crave for sports by listening to Drive Time Sports. Much like you feed your crave at any of the seven Eat My Catfish locations. the number one sports radio show in Arkansas. Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. In a moment, we'll be rejoined by Matt Zimmerman, thanks to the DHR Group of Sonic Drive-Ins. But first, let's talk with Neil Atkinson, a man from Bet Saracen. Crazy day, the opening of Major League Baseball. The official opening, by the way. Forget that stuff over in Korea.
That was kind of throwing me for a loop a little bit, like Rick. I think I'm on Rick's team on that one, especially by them doing that last week. But anyway, yeah, we've got opening day. Bet Saracen has a little bit of opening day jitters, I guess. Had a little problem with our prop feed, so those are taking us a little bit longer to grade those. So if you got Major League Baseball props, be patient. We're having to manually grade those right now until we get our fix deployed. We hope to get that fixed overnight. So should not affect any of the props or any of the bets on NCAA or any of the other markets, just your NBA player props, not the regular market. So we'll do that. But, yeah, got that going on. Got the start of the Sweet 16 tonight, a lot of anticipated games. And then I know this series has been circled on my calendar, LSU versus Arkansas. And, hey, we're in for a great weekend in baseball, both in pro and especially with the Hogs here on this what's going to be a beautiful Easter weekend.
I know you've had your hands full today, Matt, with all the other technical issues that you were just referencing, but I started the program by saying this felt like a March Madness, a Sweet 16 type of matchup with Arkansas and LSU in baseball, and unless something's changed, you had it at basically Arkansas favored by a point and a half, 1.5 runs. And I think the over-under was, what, 8.5 last time I checked, or was that?
It's up to 9.5.
Okay. Woo! That's pretty high, I would think, for this kind of pitching that we're going to see tonight. But nevertheless, you never know. It's always crazy. So you got a lot going on at Bet Saracen. So where does someone have fun and get into on all this action?
Well, on the web, go to BetSaracen.com or on your phone. Go either to the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. Type in Bet Saracen and download. In as little as 5 minutes, you can register and get in on all this fun action. Prop flash bets or live and active at that next pitch. Boy, it's getting a lot of action today. People really miss that. Didn't have it on spring training. Now it's live for opening day. And look for all the action tonight in the NCAA tournament. And have a lot of fun and win some parlays out there, people.
And we will talk with you tomorrow. That is Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. BetSaracen.com. Go get the app in the App Store at Bet Saracen. All right, let's check in with Travis. Travis, good afternoon. You have a question or comment for Matt.
Good afternoon, guys.
Good afternoon.
Matt, good talking to you, Coach Zimmerman. And Randy, go Yankees.
How about them Yankees?
It's 4-3. They were down 4-0, and they had a big inning in the fifth, so it's 4-3 last I looked. Houston.
There we go. Well, my question is on the NIL stuff with the Edge and with the school, is there any kind of training or education going on for these students that are all of a sudden finding a lot more change in their pocket? You know, with the NBA and NFL, they have, that's one of the big things they do with their rookies is how to deal with this wealth that they're about to get in these checks. And for some of these, ball players, it may not seem like a ton of wealth. Well, some of it is a ton of wealth, but you know what I'm saying? For even the guys that, the $60,000-$70,000, that's a lot more than they're used to seeing. And for any 18, 19-year-old, that's I don't care what kind of house you've grown up in, that's a hard thing to deal with, and you need someone guiding you through that. Are they just depending on parents to do that, or is the school, or is that part of what the Edge is doing, or is there any kind of systems in place to help them through that? Because I could see that could be some major issues for some of these students and players as they this continues, especially with little amount of oversight that it has already.
All right, Travis, thank you. Good question.
And by the way, your team, the Yankees, has tied Houston 4-4 in the bottom of the sixth at Houston.
Good.
Wow.
Long way to go.
Cardinals, I think, are getting beat. Cardinals are losing to the Dodgers.
5-1.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But for what his question is, and so definitely an edge has people, but they're just now getting going. And Sydney, who's a former gymnast at Arkansas, is very involved in edge, and she does a lot of that stuff. She spends a lot of time with the athlete as the connector between Arkansas edge and her being boots on the ground right here and dealing with them day to day. The other thing is at the University of Arkansas, period, and they've had to turn some of the attention to dealing with some of the athletes. A lot of the athletes have a lot more money now than they did before, and they get that through our student-athlete success department, which is ran through the Jones Center, and all the folks there, whether it's Felicia Sain through there or Justin Johnson or Richard Smith, former Razorback football player, they do a lot of things with those student-athletes. And like he said, they do it in the NBA, they do it in the NFL, but there's always going to be some that don't handle it as well. And so they do have to spend some time with them because they have to file taxes too. And it's different filing taxes when you're 19 years old and all of your school and all of your books and all of your meals and all of your training table, everything's paid for, and you're making $100,000. And so they have to pay taxes. And so there's a lot of stuff on taxes. They take tax classes. But they do get a lot of training through our student-athlete success department, which is an actual part of our athletic department. And we had that before NIL. They were trying to prepare these young people to be successful in life when they leave the University of Arkansas because they're not all going to play in the NFL. And so, but now that has really had to step up, especially in the finance department, because some of these people are really making some very good money.
This, by the way, from April, by way of our live feedback, she says, I happen to handle the NIL paperwork for my husband's company. He has deals with 8 to 10 athletes from Louisiana, Arkansas, and Mississippi. And trust me, Ole Miss is light years ahead of everyone when it comes to funding and the ease of getting a kid his money. Interesting. Okay.
Yeah.
Lynn in Sherwood says if coaches could contribute to NIL out of their own pocket, if you think coaches' salaries are ridiculous now, just think what they would skyrocket to. It would be the loophole that colleges would use to buy athletes. They would give coaches huge increases with stipulations that a large portion of it had to be allocated to NIL funds.
Yeah.
Good point.
You know, one thing I think that on NIL, and I've been saying this for a while, and people laugh at me as I say it around the university. I think every national champion in any sport, one thing that they should have to do is report what their NIL was and sit down each kid and having a kid sign off on what they got. And you don't have to tell the public what the player, the point guard at UConn got last year. But as a whole team, what did UConn spend last year on NIL? And it might surprise a lot of people. And it might be a lower number than you think. It might be a huge number. And that way all the schools know, well, this team won the national championship, and they spent $700,000 for their basketball team on NIL. Oh, I figured they spent $4 or $5 million. No, they spent $700,000. And I think they should make the NCAA champion after you clear what they spent.
Why not then expand it to those in the entire NCAA tournament? Just make it anonymous.
Yeah.
All right, man.
Some of those will be nothing.
It has been an honor to have you on. We look forward to next fall. Thank you, Matt. Matt Zimmerman, thanks again to the DHR Group of Sonic Drive-Ins.
With the Spring and Savings Cash Rebate Program at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart. With a purchase of any new FNX 45 tactical pistol, you can claim a $150 rebate. Or purchase select new FN 509 tactical or Edge Series models and claim $125 in rebates. You can even purchase select FN 509 standard or MRD models to claim $100 in rebates. But hurry before time runs out. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today and visit Max Prairie Wings or click online at maxpw.com.
Now's the time to get a great deal on proven Kubota farming equipment. Tractors that are adaptable, versatile, and rated number one in durability and owner experience. Hay tools that are backed by a two-year warranty. And durable Sidekick utility vehicles and SVL track loaders. Right now, bring home select Kubota equipment for zero down, 0% APR for up to 48 months, now through March 31st. Visit KubotaUSA.com for full details. Hennard Foothills Equipment, South Main Street in Searcy. Your hometown Kubota dealer, no matter where you live.
Join the guys Friday morning bringing the mayhem to Fletcher Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Sherwood. Stop by or check out their selection of new and pre-owned vehicles at FletcherDeals.com.
This is Chuck Barron inviting you to listen to me call the hogs on 103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock. The Razorbacks are coming at you.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
The Arkansas Department of Parks, Heritage, and Tourism is awarding $4.3 million in outdoor recreation grants to 29 counties. Those grants come in the form of facilities for underdeveloped neighborhood or fun park grants and matching grants. The money will be used to develop public parks, adding amenities, and improving accessibility. The Arkansas Legislative Audit Committee has completed a report into the purchase of a $19,000 lectern by the governor's office. The committee is now waiting on a management response from the governor's office before finishing a final draft of that audit. Governor Sanders' office was originally supposed to submit that response on Friday, but they've requested an extension. The auditor says the final report is now expected to be done in early April. That audit officially started in October 23 after a request from State Senator Jimmy Hickey Jr. For more news and weather, download our free KATV News and Weather app. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Anywhere in the state, dial 888-888-8888 for Rainwater Holton Sexton. They'll help you weather the storm.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Mostly sunny skies continue and a little bit of a warm-up. A chilly start today, but up to 68 this afternoon. Tonight's low just down to 45, 76 for Friday, and upper 70s near 80 degrees by Easter. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Want to thank the folks at Triple C in Conway today for hosting Roger and Baz. Also want to thank Will McIntyre, as well as Hannah Gamble, Melinda Mayo, Joe Klein, Tommy Smith, who all checked in today. Friday's show is live out at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood, and a special Friday edition of Justin Moore on the show. It's all coming up on a Friday edition of Morning Mayhem, 6 to 10 a.m. right here on 103.7 The Buzz.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes at Conway.
Hello, Buzz listeners. It's Chris Zender, and it's the end of the month, and Fletcher Dodge needs to sell 25 new vehicles before Monday night. We've got 0% financing on new Rams for 72 months, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. It's your choice. This ends Monday night, so give us a chance to show you how great 0% is. We also have new 2024 Jeep Compass four-wheel drives for only $424 a month, with zero down and no gimmicks. For you heavy-duty truck owners, we also have brand new 2024 Ram 2500 Crew Cab four-wheel drives priced to sell starting at $49,997. We'll do whatever it takes to make you a deal between now and Monday night, so come see us today. Don't worry about your credit. At Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade, and also a hassle-free buying experience. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood, or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. We also have free delivery to your house or work.
Mark Norman, you don't say, Tor.
Hate the small talk. Two things I can't do, small talk and eye contact. How sad is that, you know? I basically have all the traits of a serial killer, just without the ambition. I'm working on it. People say, Mark, gotta be more confident. They say, Mark, gotta be yourself. I'm like, well, you gotta pick one.
Fresh off his Netflix special, Soup to Nuts, see Mark Norman live on stage this Saturday at Robinson Center. Get tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like Triple C Sales and Service in Conway or Lawn and Power in Star City.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock is now open. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One, now open in West Little Rock.
Start spring in style, comfort, and power behind the wheel of a brand new 2024 Chevy Silverado. Guatney Chevrolet has interest rates as low as 2.9% for 72 months on Silverado pickup trucks. Spend less money and get more out of your drive at Guatney Chevrolet. Head to 1301 TP White Drive in Jacksonville to take advantage of fantastic interest rates on new Chevy Silverados. Chevrolet, together, let's drive. 2.9% APR for 72 months. Must finance with GM Financial. Some customers may not qualify. Not available with lease and some other offers. Take new retail delivery by April 30th, 2024.
It's the Ranger Open House Sale through Monday at Bradford Marine and ATV at all 6 statewide locations. Last of the boat show deals, like the Ranger 520R with 250 horsepower Mercury with trailer and up to a $2,000 Bass Pro gift card and discounts up to $10,000 on select models. Or check out the SunTracker Sportfish 22, great for fishing and cruising with 115 horsepower Mercury outboard. Don't miss the Open House Sale today through April 1st at all Bradford Marine and ATV statewide locations. Your authorized Ranger and Tracker dealer.
Live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number two at Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. This program note, we will be leaving in a matter of less than 25 minutes to join Arkansas Razorback Baseball with the pregame, Arkansas LSU. So keep your dial set right where it is. My question that I have right now, the major question, do I go tonight? Do I go tomorrow night? And do I go Saturday night? And that is to the Riverfront Steakhouse in North Little Rock because of the dinner for two for $60. I can't beat the deal. It is simply too good of a deal to beat. So do I go tonight? Do I go tomorrow night? Do I go Saturday night? Because I want the Riverfront Salad Bar for two. I want the entree, which is the filet, 10 ounce, plus four. We will double that number. Of the double F fried shrimp. And then we will get, Gary always loves the hibachi fried rice with chicken. I prefer the baked potato. But the beautiful thing is they're both so big, we can share. We can cut up the baked potato, that baked potato the size of a NFL football, and that hibachi fried rice with chicken. I'm happy. She's happy. And there's still plenty to spare. So 3719,000. Make your reservation tonight. Make it tomorrow night. Make it Saturday night. And take advantage of this fantastic deal. Dinner for two for $60 at the Riverfront Steakhouse, Wyndham Hotel in North Little Rock. As for Shapur in making that reservation, 3719,000. Riverfront Steakhouse in North Little Rock.
And now, Trey Biddy is brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai, Arkansas's number one Hyundai dealer, and Genesis of Conway, Arkansas's only Genesis dealer. Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today. Now, here's Trey Biddy.
Rick, I've got to tell you, it was as close to the ultimate. When I went to hogsports.com today, and there was Trey Biddy with a story. Headline, Arkansas spring football, fastball, depth chart, day seven. Because this, and what Trey's going to tell you, that you have to disregard, the fastball starts because they do change, they do mix things up. I don't care, Trey. I saw it on paper. I got to see Talon Green as the starting quarterback. Jacoby Criswell, number two. K.J. Jackson, number three. But then Trey goes into a little bit of a dialogue. He says, Jacoby Criswell came out with the second bunch where Malachi Singleton had previously been. But later, in 11-on-11 and 7-on-7, Singleton was with the second group. So any adjustments that are being made, Trey pointed that out, that this is the way it was for the fastball, not necessarily what you might see in the 11-on-11 or the 7-on-7. So thank you, Trey. I finally have something I can sink my teeth into.
Well, we like to do that because I think it is a pretty decent representation, especially when you combine everything that's happened over the 7 days of practice. You know, it gives you – let's say this. Talon Green – I'm naming Talon Green the starting quarterback at Arkansas officially.
Wow, you that? Are?
Yeah, I'm naming him.
In spite of what Sam may have said today in his press conference.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm naming him the starter.
Trey Biddy has been given authority.
There he goes. Yep.
I mean, it's obvious. I mean, he's taking every single first-team snap. I mean, every single one of them. And it's not just the fastball period, which they just, you know, run four quick plays with the first, second, third team. But it's every 7-on-7. It's every 11-on-11. And it'll be throughout the scrimmage. Maybe they'll give somebody, maybe Malachi Singleton gets a little bit of reps or something in the scrimmage on Saturday. But, no, this has been going on for seven straight practices. I don't see any reason that it's not going to continue. Talon Green's the starting quarterback. I felt that from the first practice, just watching them all out there side by side. I felt like it was fairly obvious then. So if you can take anything away from this depth chart, take that away, that Talon Green's the starting quarterback. And I believe Malachi Singleton is the number two. I haven't seen Jacoby do anything to, you know, jump over those guys really. And, you know, Singleton is also younger. So that's – I think that's pretty well established. Now, you look at running back, I think there's maybe a little bit more leeway there. I do think Jaquindon Jackson will end up being the starter at running back. I just think he's got all the tools that you're looking for, plus experience. But, you know, just Binion has done some good things in his career at Arkansas. So has Isaiah Gustav, what he run for 181 yards or something in the last two games. You know, Dominic Johnson has certainly had you know, maybe it's not like he was back in 2021, but he's done some good things for Arkansas too. And Braylon Russell, certainly intriguing. Wide receiver, I mean, Andrew Armstrong's a go-to wide receiver. I mean, that's been pretty obvious too throughout camp. Now, he did tweak a hamstring a little bit today early in practice doing one-on-ones against Jalen Braxton, but he's been super consistent. And you know, it's not a bad-looking group of wide receivers with Armstrong and Tyrone Broden has done some – Tyrone Broden probably the star of the day. You know, Isaiah Cetania also has done some really good things. And, you know, Jaden Wilson has too, and Isaac Teslaw. They've got some consistent targets at wide receiver and at tight end. I think they've got some weapons at tight end. Andreas Puska was out today. He's got a thumb issue. He was out today. But Varkeys Gums, as I mentioned, has looked a lot more comfortable. So, you know. And the offensive line, aside from the first day when Takias Crawford was starting at right tackle, the offensive line has remained the same. It has not changed. Fernando Carmona, left tackle. Patrick Kudus, left guard. Addison Nichols, center. Joshua Braun, right guard. Keyshawn Blackstock, right tackle. Now, I think they'll do some work in the transfer portal still. Need to add a couple of guys, but, I mean, that's remained pretty consistent. Defense has been pretty consistent. I could see a little bit of a battle, you know, still going with Nico Davier and Anton Junkaj, I think. But throughout practices, it's been Davier at left end, Gregory at left defensive tackle, Cam Ball at right defensive tackle, Landon Jackson at right defensive end. And it's and the second group has been the same, too, throughout pretty much all of practice now, except for, you know, when they go with that mint front and they have you know, they have basically three defensive linemen, and they'll bring in Brad Spence, you know, or leave Nico Davier in there. And then, you know, linebacker, the only reason linebacker has mixed up a little bit is because Spence has been working at that buck spot with the second group. But otherwise, it's been Brad Spence and Xavion Sori and Carson Dean when Spence is with the second group working at the buck. So all that stuff has remained the same. The secondaries remain the same. Everything has pretty much remained the same, especially with the first group throughout seven practices of camp, which is also a good thing because that means there's not a lot of injuries.
And why was Broden the star of the day today?
He had a really – well, he had a couple of nice grabs. He had a few grabs, actually. But the one that really jumped out, Taylen Green just kind of overthrew him, which is hard to do because he's 6'7" and can really run. But it was about 41 yards downfield on 7-on-7. He went up against Keon Stewart, who, you know, Keon, there, I don't know that there was anything he possibly could have done to stop this. Broden just made a diving catch 41 yards downfield, like had to extend out and get it, you know, landing on his side. So it was a really, really good catch by him. And he's done really good things, you know, all throughout camp. You can tell he's noticeably thicker. He's definitely put on weight. You know, just looking at the numbers that he put out today. So in 7-on-7, he had two catches for 49 yards. One of those was that the 41-yarder. And 1-on-1, he had one catch for 7 yards. And let's see. Here we go. Two catches for 36 yards. He had a couple of nice grabs in 11-on-11 also. But that one catch was pretty impressive from him. He's had a really good good spring so far.
All right, Trey, this is concerning the tight end position. I realize he's not ready for pads or anything else, but what is an update on Ty Washington?
He's been in green. I don't recall seeing him out there today. They may do on-off with him, but he was in green on Tuesday, and he's slowly supposed to be working his way back in. You know, he had the dislocated shoulder that required surgery mid-late season last year, so it's taken him a little bit longer to come back. But, you know, they're in pretty good shape. Obviously, they're without Puska today, who's kind of had a – I guess it, the way Pittman was explaining it today, it's something that he had at – Eastern Michigan too, so it's kind of followed him around a little bit. So hopefully that won't be a long-term issue. But Varkeys Gums has looked really good in practice. I mean, when they put Varkeys and Luke Haz out there in 12 personnel, I mean, that's a couple of nice weapons at tight end that can cause some mismatches.
I was going to ask you, there was another question I had. What percentage can you see the 12 personnel?
Well, I definitely think they'll use it a good bit. You know, they do some four wide stuff too. I've seen them run a little empty, but mostly 11 personnel, three wide receivers, and 12 personnel. A pretty decent bit. I mean, it's kind of interesting the way they do this. I don't know why they have this pattern, but a lot of times, I would say the majority of times, you know, the first group will go out there and they'll be in 11 personnel, and then the second group will go out there and they'll be in 12 personnel with the two tight ends. And the defense will go out, first team, and they'll be in a 4-2-5. And then the second group will come out, and they'll be in the mint. So, you know, with basically, I mean, it's the same personnel. It's just Nico Davier's – well, excuse me, it's not Nico Davier. It's Brad Spence with the second group playing basically an edge rusher. Is basically like in a two-point stance up at the line of scrimmage. So I don't know why they've done it that way consistently, but I put those little notes under there because when the second group comes out and they have two tight ends, that takes the slot out. And when the slot out, that means Isaiah Cetania is not in there. And it never fails that I get questions, where's Isaiah Cetania? Mm-hmm. You know, so I make sure to put those little notes at the bottom.
Very effective, by the way. Maddox Lassiter is running number two as a tight end, then Shamar Easter. I keep waiting for Shamar Easter.
Maddox was in there today because Puska was out.
Yeah, but I keep waiting for Shamar Easter to make a move.
Easter's been in there a bit. You know, he's, you know, when they're doing 11-on-11 stuff, he's been with the second group some, you know, primarily when they've done the 12 personnel. But, you know, Easter has a lot of potential. He's just not quite there yet from a strength standpoint. You know, this is a guy that ran, I believe they had him at 21.7 miles per hour, which was, I don't believe anybody within 20 pounds of him was like, you know, was close to that, that speed. So he's got speed and he's got size. It's just, he's got size potential, I should say. He's about 227. You know, one day he'll be 245 or so, 250 maybe. And all of 6'5", he looks taller than that. And will be a really good player for them. But they've got a lot of tight ends ahead of him, and he's just kind of been a guy with potential until he realizes that potential. That's who he is right now.
Well, he ought to be great this weekend.
Okay. Hopefully he'll get a lot of eggs in his basket this weekend, this Saturday especially. Trey, what kind of push are you seeing – from the second team offensive lineman? As an example, Emarion Harris, heard good things about him. Left tackle, Josh Street at left guard, backing up Kudus. Then you got Amari Wiggins backing up Addison Nichols. I won't go through the remainder of the offensive line. Is there any kind of push being made from the second team providing competition?
Well, potentially. I mean, I don't – I mean, maybe Takis Crawford over at right tackle. Mm-hmm. You know, he was there with the first group on day one, and then it's been Keyshawn Blackstock since then. But, you know, I wouldn't say that, like, I don't think that Amari Wiggins is, you know, making a serious push at Addison Nichols for that center job. Maybe if they were to get Branson Hickman, maybe there's a battle there and we, you know, see a little bit more shakeup. You know, Kobe Branham is just a freshman, and he's been behind Joshua Braun, which is encouraging to see a freshman with a second group. He's been working ahead of Luke Brown, who's in his second year coming up. But I don't know. I don't know if I see, you know, Crawford overcoming Blackstock. I see Crawford kind of as the, you know, sixth man in a lot of ways on the offensive line. Branham's not taking over Josh Braun. Wiggins isn't taking over Addison Nichols. Street isn't taking over Patrick Kudus. And Emarion, I don't, you know, he's not taking over Fernando Carmona right now. But I will say, because I go over and watch Sam Pittman working with the offensive line, he actually works with the offensive tackles during the individual stuff I watch. It'll be Eric Mateos, he'll be working with the guards, and Pittman's over there working with the tackles. And from watching him work with Emarion, he seems really encouraged with Emarion. And Emarion's been a guy that, you know, he came in at, what was he, 380 or something?
Yeah, 380, 385.
Yeah. Yeah. And they got him all the way down to 297. So took off all the bad weight and putting on good weight after. He looks a lot better. He looked really slim when I saw him, you know, last August. So putting on good weight on him, and, you know, just from Pittman's reaction to some of the things he's doing in drills and stuff, he seems like he's pretty encouraged with him.
When's the last time he was allowed to eat? Good gracious, you lose almost 100 pounds.
Yeah, that's
wow. That must be a starvation diet. All right, Trey, any updates on Hickman? You mentioned Hickman a few moments ago.
Yeah.
The transfer coming out of SMU, any updates on him?
I was talking to Danny about him, and, I mean, sounds like he's going to, you know, take some time and take some visits. And, I mean, TCU is definitely a player for him also. So TCU might be the school to watch in contention with Arkansas. But, yeah, I think he's going to take some visits and then make a decision. So no real rush. And that's kind of, you know, to be honest, in basketball side of things, that's kind of the same stuff. It's not as fast as it was last year. Just, you know, not just with Arkansas, but around the country. It seems like players are doing their due diligence a little more.
Hmm. All right, let's talk with Tony. Tony, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Trey?
Yes, Rand. How you guys doing?
Hey, buddy. Today? How are you, Tony?
Pretty good. I was going to ask that SMU, you know, Hickman. Also, you guys already answered that, so I'm going to ask who else are we looking at the offensive lineman spot? And I'll hang up and listen. God bless.
Thank you, Tony.
I mean, I'll look to find out, but I've been just consumed with spring football, so. And I think the coaches kind of have too, but, you know, there's been visitors coming in for recruiting and things like that. But I will try to find the answer to that.
Trey, this by way of our live fan feedback, Freddie says, Pittman mentioned Slaughter today. Could he move to safety and start?
I saw him work in safety early, and Pittman said, you know, he looks just as good as anybody they've got out there. He has been working – generally been working back up at the nickel spot behind Snacks Johnson, but all those guys are, you know, pretty much know every spot. I mean, last year Hudson Clark worked at, you know, he was generally the field safety, but he also worked at nickel. Snacks worked at corner and worked at nickel. We have not seen him work anywhere but nickel this spring. But I have seen Denico Slaughter work safety and nickel, but lately just nickel. So I think that Slaughter is probably, when you talk about the safeties and nickels, I think he's probably, I mean, Pittman says he's just as good as any of them, but he's probably, you know, the fourth guy for three spots right now. That's how I bet it would play out. If, like, somebody got dinged up, Jaden Johnson, say he got dinged up or something, I think you'd see Slaughter come in. If you saw Snacks Johnson get dinged up, I think you'd see Slaughter come in at that spot too.
Trey, I noticed also on the depth chart, the field safety, you mentioned it with Hudson Clark a moment ago, the field safety and the boundary safety, I thought those terms had been pretty much done away with because you now got right and left cornerback.
Yeah.
Is there a reason they went back to the designation of the field safety and the boundary safety?
No, they've been doing that. Now, safety is easier to flip to the field and the boundary just because they're closer together. With cornerbacks, if you're going to flip cornerbacks, then you've got to do it, you know, they've got to sprint to 50 yards to the other side of the field.
Right.
So it just doesn't make a whole lot of sense to designate a boundary safety, or excuse me, a boundary corner and a field corner. So, but they do that with the safety spots.
Gotcha. Okay. Because I had thought, and maybe at one time it was field and boundary corner. I just seem like I remember that phrase going away. Nice article, by the way, on the running back, Jaquindon Jackson. But I noticed on the depth chart that number three was Braylon Russell. Looks like Braylon's starting to make a move.
Yeah, I mean, they mix those guys up very frequently. Now, the last couple of days, Jaquindon Jackson has been with the first group both times. But, you know, on Tuesday, I don't think Braylon Russell was in the three deep. I think Dominic Johnson and Isaiah Augusta were in the, you know, in that. And this time, DeBinion and Braylon Russell were. So they've got a number of guys. I tried to pin Sam Pittman down on that. Like, do you feel like you have a 1,000-yard back? And he said, we feel like we got a lot of guys that can average 4.5, 5.5 yards a carry.
Coming up next, Arkansas Razorback Baseball. Stay tuned.
Arkansas, land of opportunity, Arkansas. I want you to do to me the prettiest place that I ever saw was back home in Arkansas. All those boyhood memories, lakes and rivers and blackwood trees, gentle mountains reach to the sky. Oh, how I hated to say goodbye to Arkansas, land of opportunity, Arkansas. I want you to do to me the prettiest place that I ever saw. Back home in Arkansas, dirt roads that lead nowhere, except the houses in need repair. Front porch people wearing a smile, and they cover every mile of Arkansas, land of opportunity, Arkansas. Oh, what you do to me, the prettiest place that I ever saw was back home in Arkansas. I can see my dad back home, working Pike County sand phone. Mama calling me from the door, oh, how I want once more to Arkansas, land of opportunity, Arkansas. Oh, what you do to me, the prettiest place that I ever saw was back home in Arkansas. One more time, yeah, Arkansas, land of opportunity, Arkansas. Oh, what you do to me, the prettiest place that I ever saw is back home in Arkansas. Yeah.
Hogs throw it into Battle. Battle lets one fly. No good at the horn. And in overtime, Alabama's won the game. Heck of a ball game. In overtime, Alabama wins it.